and forever in your life. So with that being said, Officer Malloy and the Wheatridge Police Department has graciously put together this presentation, and so I'm going to turn it over to him.
You guys spend all day getting talked to by adults, and I don't want to do that much. We're not going to take a lot of your time. You guys know me. I'm pretty laid back, but I'm also subtle like a brick to the head. What you're going to see today is we had to kind of stretch it out. It happened very quickly. There's events that are going to unfold in front of you. Happened very quickly. It's going to seem like it's taken a long time, but it didn't. And things were going on simultaneously, but in order to make it work for the PowerPoint so that you guys could see this, we had to stretch it out. So that being said, a year ago this weekend, one moron, and that's what he was, made a very bad mistake, decided to drink, become intoxicated, and then drive. And in doing so, he caused and was in a fatal accident right over here at this intersection, 32nd and Kipling. And after he caused that accident, he did the classy, courageous thing, and he left the scene of the accident at that point, leaving his wife, two small babies, and Jordan Sprouse at the scene. He fled on foot. Police were able to contact him and arrest him, and as a result, he ended up going to jail, and he's going to do 34 years in prison. So what we're going to show you right now, what I ask you to do, is pay attention, try to take from it what you can, get something out of it. Understand we have a lot of guests in the school right now, that some pretty heavy hitter guests that are here. Try to show them what Wheatridge High School is all about, i.e. behave, be the type of people you are with me normally, and get something out of this. It will probably strike a nerve with some of you. It's meant to, all right? We have people on scene in the form of counselors and other counselors that we brought in extra. If some of you have a desire to talk about this when it's over, all that I ask you to do is pay attention. Go.
Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Wait, where's 911?
Yeah, it's a major emergency accident on the corner of 32nd and Kipling, just happened.
Okay, 32nd and Kipling, you said?
Right at the stoplight.
Okay, can you tell if anyone's hurt?
No, I don't know, there's a lot of running, there's a lot of things going on, there's at least three or four cars involved.
Alright, we'll get them out.
We'll get them out. People out there, okay.
Okay, thank you.
Wait, you're 911, you're going to the accident, 32nd Kipling?
No.
Were you involved?
No, I'm taking my guy.
Okay. It was he hit run now?
Oh, he's running, he left his car.
Okay.
White T-shirt, 5'7", 1 inch, we couldn't see his foot. Left the rifle, we said, why in the baby? Got a chain hand on the right side of his waist.
And he has a what in the right side of his waist?
A chain.
Chain.
He ran behind the house. I can't see an address. Dude, what's your address? There's a guy in your backyard. What's your address? There's a guy doing in your backyard. He went back there. He might still be back there. Don't go back there. He just caused a big wreck.
Okay, and which way did he go?
I'm on this. What's your address? 62 Hillside Road. He went in the backyard and was fleeing.
Okay. And that's where the suspect is now?
Well, when he ran through, it's been about a minute, and he was self-defensive.
Alright, just a second, I'll be right back with you. Just a moment, don't hang up.
Do you have
Commissioner Nielsen?
28.
14.
Yeah, 14.
I think back there, that location, they live on that east, southbound through the state grid somewhere.
28.
And for the revised, he may be trying to make his way to things and hold back to an unknown address there.
84, back home, checking your name.
28.
Is it, 84, 27? Okay, last known sighting of this guy was backyard of, I think, 62 or 26, 27.
Yeah, he checked that, Kurt. That's where we lost his track, I see where he's jumping, that's the city we.
Okay.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile, but then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get over, you're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you? Slow down, you're doing fine. You can't be everything you wanna be before your time. Although it's so romantic on the borderline tonight, tonight. yellow waits for you.
Responded to that night, and a lot of people did a really good job and showed a lot of good police work on that. A lot of citizens showed a lot of good citizenship by coming forward the way that they did. But I want to introduce a couple people right now, or at least point them out and give you guys the opportunity to ask them any questions that you may have. I have the officer that showed up first on scene, whose call this actually was. It was Officer Shaw. I have him. I have the detective that actually handled the case. Where's Detective Sarsky? Right there. I have the two DAs that prosecuted it, that were able to get this guy sent to prison, which I don't think 34 years is long enough for taking somebody else's life. But that's what they were able to do, which they did a heck of a job on that too. It's just my personal opinion, that isn't long enough. But those gentlemen's name are, my eyes are old, D.A. Jed Greenblast and D.A. Brad Maloney. They also did a good job. Two other people are in attendance in this presentation right now, too, that I'm not going to point them out, but I do. They deserve special recognition for being here, for allowing us to put this presentation on, because they care enough about their family member. And they care enough about you guys. And you guys knew, a lot of you guys knew Jordan. And that's Jordan's sister, Morgan Sprouse, and Jordan's mother, Jesse Ackerman. They're in attendance right now as well. So, that being said, I'll open it up. If any of you have any questions that you'd like to ask any of these people, now's your opportunity. If you don't have any questions, the car that Jordan was driving that night is parked out front in the fire lane. And I want to point something out real quick, too. Jordan was not drunk that night at all. And he did not deserve to die that night in the manner that he did, because one idiot made the poor choices that he did. So you guys have worked long and hard to get to this point in your life. Give your mom and dad the pleasure, the honor of helping you get ready for prom this weekend without having to worry that you're going to go out and meet with a tragedy like what happened a year ago this weekend to the Sprouse family. That's just not right. Have fun this weekend, but be smart, make good decisions. Like I said, in the beginning, I realize this is going to touch a nerve with some of you. If it does, you have your high school counselors, which, in my opinion, are the best I've ever worked with. And number two, we have people from victim outreach information counselors that will help you with this as well. So as this thing goes on throughout the rest of the day and even next week, if you need some help, if you need to talk to somebody, let somebody know in this building and we'll put you in touch with the proper people. Thank you.
Follow up with that again. If you need to talk to someone in regards to the emotions that this has brought up, we are available. The other thing to that is I do want you to stop by and take a look at the car and see the impact that it had on that particular car, therefore you know the impact that it had on Jordan's body. Okay, and again, I can't stress the importance of good decisions. Okay, there are many other ways to have fun, and you don't need to be drunk or high to do that. And I know prom is, you know, a time where you get to spread your wings and, you know, let go. Don't do it that way, please. Or any time, I would tell you, don't do it at any time that way, okay? Mr. Worth, did you have any further words that you would like to share?
I think you guys said what needs to be said.
And Stanley, we're good? And what time? encourage you guys to do is to walk outside, take a look at the vehicle, okay? And then you can stay there for just a few minutes, and then we're going to head back to third period, okay? Thank you guys for your attention. And again, thank you to the Sprouses and everybody who presented.